يا إمام الرسل يا سندي أنت باب الله معتمدي فبدنياي وآخرتي
يا رسول الله
خذ بيدي.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations, peace and blessings upon the best of creation, the jewel and crown of creation, the beloved of Allah Almighty, the coolness to our eyes, the purpose of our lives, the reviver of our hearts, the inspirer to our minds, the awakener of our souls, the most honored one, the most praised one, the most generous one, the most kind one. Undoubtedly, he is the most beautiful one, none other than Sayyiduna Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa barak wa sallam. As we all know and understand, in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam holds the highest rank and maqam. And his position in the creation of Allah Almighty is the best and the greatest from all of the creation of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Therefore, anything that is connected, attached and attributed to him, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, this also automatically becomes great in their respective fields. So as Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is the greatest Nabi of Allah, then the book that was revealed, the Kitabullah al-Majid, Al-Quran al-Kareem, this is the greatest book over all other divine books that Allah Almighty revealed. The city of Rasulullah والسلام, is the best of all cities. The companions of Nabi والسلام, are the best of all companions. The ummah of Rasulullah والسلام, is the best of all ummahs. And based upon this qaida and principle, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam's family is the best of all families. And his family are referred to in the Quran as Ahlul Bayt, household, people of the household, people of the prophetic household. Ahlul Baytun Nabawi, Ahlul Baytin Nabawi, the prophetic household of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Ahlul Bayt of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam consists of Sayyiduna Ali bin Abi Talib, Sayyida Fatimatu Zahra, Sayyiduna Imam al-Hasan and Sayyiduna Imam al-Husayn radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. And along with them, it also includes Nabi alayhi salat wa salam's blessed wives, the azwaji mutahharat. In Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah Almighty mentions them as our mothers. He refers to them as our mothers. النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتهم. The messenger is closer to you than even your own selves, your own lives, and his wives are their mothers. The mothers of the believers, أمهات المؤمنين, أزواج مطهرات. And that verse in the Quran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to the Ahlul Bayt, the verses prior to this were revealed in relation to the blessed wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah Almighty said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرُّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَاهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. That Allah Almighty intends to purify the people of the house. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرُّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ. Allah Almighty intends to remove rijs from the Ahlul Bayt. Remove rijs. Rijs refers to as all evil actions and characteristics. Allah Almighty removed all of this from those who are in the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. And He purified them. He purifies you the best of purifications. وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. And Allah Almighty here is referring to the blessed wives of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, and also referring to Sayyidah Fatima, Sayyiduna Ali, Sayyiduna Hassan and Hussein radiyallahu anhum ajma'een. And these are the Ahlul Bayt of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And for them, it is necessary, it is a fundamental aspect of our iman, our faith, that we love them and we honor them and we respect them. And Allah said in the Quran, say to them, O my beloved, I don't ask you for anything except that you love my close ones. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. That you love my close ones, those who are closest to me, and who are the ones closest to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. When asked this question, مَنْ كَرَابَتُكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Who are the close ones to you? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, Ali wa Fatima wa banahuma. Ali, Fatima and their two sons, these are the ones closest to me. And here Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, through the words of Allah Jalla wa Ala, is ordering us that it is necessary for us, it is fard upon us, the ummah, that we love the Ahlul Bayt, we love the family of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. The Anbiya wa Rusul did not ask for anything, for Allah Almighty gave them everything. They did not need anything from their people. But when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam here is saying that I'm only asking from you, I'm only asking you to love my family, then you can understand its importance and greatness. That if Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has never asked the ummah for anything except love for his family, it is necessary upon us that we move forward in this love for the Ahlul Bayt. We love the household of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. And we honor them. About the household, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, my house, my household, the people of my home are like the ark of Sayyidina Nuh, Noah's ark. He who sets foot upon this ark will be saved. And he who does not mount upon this ark, who does not embark upon this journey upon this ark, they will be destroyed. For Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam uses this as a metaphor to exemplify and to emphasize the importance of the Ahlul Bayt, the importance of his family. He compares them and he metaphorically compares them to Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam's ark. When Sayyidina Nuh was sent to the people, for so many hundreds of years, he did da'wah and tabligh. He invited them towards the belief of Allah, the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People rejected him and denied him. And he asked that Allah Almighty sent upon them what he has never sent upon this earth before. Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed to Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam that he is going to send the floods. He is going to send torrential rain, which will flood the entire earth from east till west. And he ordered Sayyidina Nuh to build the ark. And he who rides upon this ark will be saved from the torrential rain and floods that Allah Jalla wa Ala will send upon mankind at that time. And those who embarked upon the ark of Sayyidina Nuh were saved. They were saved from the fitans. They were saved from the tests and the tribulations of that time. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam metaphorically is explaining to us that if you want to be saved from the fitnas of your time, if you want to be saved from the tests and trials of life and the fitnas and the trials of your time, then this is a qaida, a principle that we should hold on to. That those who hold on to the family of Rasulullah salam, they will be saved. Not only will they be saved in their lifetime, but they will also be saved in the akhirah. Those who honor and respect the Ahlul Bayt, those who love the Ahlul Bayt, and those who don't, this is not referring to those who exceed in their love. There are some who have exceeded in their love, that they have granted a self-acclaimed divinity upon the Ahlul Bayt. They have said that these are so great that they are even greater than Anbiya wa Rusul. They are greater than the prophets of Allah Almighty. This is not the belief and this is not the aqeedah and creed of the Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah. We believe that the people, those from the household of Rasulullah salatu salam, are min al-mahfuzeen. They are from those who are protected, that Allah Jalla wa Ala has granted divine protection upon them. But they are not like the Anbiya wa Rusul. They are not ma'asoom like the Anbiya wa Rusul. For only the Anbiya wa Rusul and the Malaika, the angels, are ma'asoom and they are free and saved from sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the Ahlul Bayt. As I mentioned in the verse, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Allah Almighty intends to remove impurities from the household of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people of the household, and he intends to purify them the best of purification. These are pure souls, these are pure bodies, these are pure people, pure individuals, the likes of Sayyidina Ali and Sayyidina Fatima, Sayyidina Hassan and Hussein, the likes of Sayyidina Khadija and Sayyidina Aisha, and the other blessed wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, our blessed mothers. These are those from the household of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had immense love for his family. He referred to his sahaba as the stars and his family as the ark. And those who are upon the ark need guidance of the stars. And those who hold on to the stars and take the guidance of the stars, they will not be misguided. Those who are just simply upon the ark and not taking the guidance that the stars give, they will be misguided. Those who merely look at the stars, looking for guidance, yet don't have the ride to take them to the destination, they will be misguided. In order to be guided, you must embark upon the ark, the Ahlul Bayt, hold on to them, and you must seek guidance through the stars, the ashab of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when one takes guidance from the stars and holds on to the ark and embarks upon the ark and the Ahlul Bayt and the sahaba ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, they will arrive at their destination, which is Allah and his Rasul alayhi salatu wa sallam. It is necessary upon us that we hold on to the Ahlul Bayt, we hold on to Al-Quran Al-Kareem and Ashabi Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. No doubt, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam emphasized this when he mentioned so clearly and on a number of occasions that I leave behind you two things. As long as you hold on to them and you do not leave them, you shall never be misguided. I leave behind the book of Allah. This is the rope of Allah suspended from the heavens onto this earth. Hold on to the rope of Allah, you shall never be misguided. And I leave behind Ahli Bayti wa Itrati. Wa Itrati Ahli Bayti. I leave behind my Itrat. I leave behind my Awlad, my children. I leave behind my family. And those who hold on to my family, they shall not be misguided. And here, when we refer to the family of Rasulullah, as I've mentioned, we are referring to the wives of Rasulullah. we are referring to the Panjtan Pak as they are referred in the Persian language and the Urdu language of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had immense love for them. The one whom he loved the most from his family, when asked by Sayyidina Aisha, who do you love the most? They said, I love Fatima more than I love anyone. I love my daughter more than I love anyone. Who resembled Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam the most? Sayyidina Aisha said, it was Fatima radiyallahu anha who resembled Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam the most. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, every lineage, every bloodline shall cease except mine, which shall continue till the day of judgment. My bloodline, my honor, my rank will continue through my family, through my bloodline, whom those who came after Sayyidina Imam Hassan from the bloodline of Imam Hassan and Hussein radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, the likes of Sayyidina Imam Zainul Abideen, the likes of Sayyidina Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, Sayyidina Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, Sayyidina Musa al-Kazim, Sayyidina Ali al-Taqi, Sayyidina Ali al-Naqi, Sayyidina Hassan al-Askari. And we will see the greatness of the Ahlul Bayt when the Imam shall be unveiled and he shall appear, the great Imam of the Ahlul Bayt, the final Imam of the Ahlul Bayt, whose arrival that we are awaiting for, the one who will be Al-Khalifatul A'zam on the earth, Sayyidina Imam Mahdi radiyallahu an, when he shall arrive, he is from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. He is from the descendants of Imam Hassan radiyallahu an. And his father's name will be the same name as Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam's father. And he will be from the Quraysh, from the Banu Hashim, from the children of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he shall appear just before the arrival of Dajjal. And he will amass the greatest army the Ummah will ever witness and see. He, Imam Mahdi radiyallahu an, is the one whom we eagerly await, though we don't know when he shall arrive. Only Allah has this knowledge and Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. But no doubt he is from amongst the signs of the final hour that shall appear. And he is from amongst the Imams of the Ahlul Bayt, those whom we respect and honor. And no doubt we have love and reverence towards. These are some of the words that I had to share with yourselves in relation to the Ahlul Bayt, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah jalla wa ala allow us and give us tawfiq to honor the Ahlul Bayt, to love the Ahlul Bayt. And may we be resurrected with them on the day of judgment. And may we be granted salvation on that day through the intercession of the Ahlul Bayt and the Ashab of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and through him Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and Al-Quran al-Kareem. Wa aqulu qawli hadha. أستغفر الله لي ولكم وآخر دعوايا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
يا إمام الرسل يا سندي أنت باب الله معتمدي فبدنياي وآخرتي
يا رسول الله.